So my recommendation on this one is we do it in three steps. The first step
I always mess it up towards the end with
is going to
that.
be do figure out what f of x plus h is. The second step is to figure out what the subtraction is.
Is.
The third step is to divide by h. And then I'm going to do a fourth step where we're going to do a limit. Okay. And then we'll check it. All right, so step one, what is f of x plus h? And my recommendation for that is write f of parentheses equals 2 times parentheses squared minus parentheses. Everywhere there was an x, replace it with parentheses. And then into that parentheses, we're going to plug in the x plus h.
How'd you put any friends? It's just eight, so that should be six. That's my writing back.
Okay, so that's my first recommendation. There is no shortcut for squaring something. You've got to write x plus h times x plus h, or maybe you have the formula for that memorized. Some people do.
X squared
This is
plus
f plus h
2xh
equals
plus h squared. Algebra.
and then we have to double
No, it's still true because you
all of
plug
that,
up a
because we have the times
yeah,
two
it's
there.
y. Yeah.
So that's going to be
So
2x
two.
squared for my version plus 4xh plus 2h squared. And I would recommend trying my version and then doing your version. But if you want to just, win your version at the same time, that's cool. Super careful here. I have to distribute a negative there. This is a place I commonly mess up. So that's going to be a
Yeah.
minus x minus h.
That's 6 months. Minus a percentage.
There are no like terms there.
So it's good.
There's nothing else we can do with that.
Right, so then we got to go on to the
What are you
next step,
talking about?
right?
Okay, so
So
now I'm ready for
three
step two.
six.
So step
X
two, so
over
that was my step one.
six.
Step two is to take what I found here and just subtract f of x from it. Well, you know what? That's not bad because I'm just going to write that underneath. I need to subtract
Oh, I
a
see. That's
2x
awesome.
squared.
Did you build your own?
And I
That's
need to
definitely.
subtract, hey guys, okay. And I need to subtract a negative x. Be careful with signs there. I have to subtract all of this.
So then
So
it
I have
goes
to
back to
subtract
x
the
plus.
2x, and I have to subtract a
Oh.
negative x, which is really a positive x, which cancels from above. Now stuff is starting to cancel. Okay, so what's left from step two is 4xh plus 2h squared minus h. Can I do anything to that before I move on?
Factor H out
You
of
can
that.
factor an h out. Let's do it.
Wait, and then you minus there.
4x
Wait, can you?
plus 2h minus 1 times h. And now I'm ready for step three. Use different colors. Step three is to take whatever I found above here and divide it by h. So I'm just going to go over here and write divide by h.
Bam, bam.
And yeah, like you said, bam, bam. What's left for part three is 4x plus 2h minus 1.
I don't think we take it to zero. I think it
Well, yeah,
divides that.
this one said stop there. So
Yeah.
I'm going to write that down, but I'm going to keep going.
Yeah. Oh, I should
Okay,
take it
that's
to
the time
zero
for
for this.
so the answer here is 4x minus 2h minus 1, or plus, sorry, then minus 1. That's all they want. They said, what is this fraction simplified?
Bang.
Okay, so I'm done with this problem, but I'm going to go a step further.
X minus four.
I'm going to take the limit of this as h goes to 0. So I'm going to have a step four. If I take the limit as h goes to 0 of this, what's left?
X minus one.
4x minus 1.
Wait. If you so you said to find any point.
That's what
Like
I'm
even
getting
the
at.
last
So here's
one.
what I know. Here's what I know. Since I took the limit, I have found what's called f prime of x. And for this function, f prime of x is 4x minus 1. This is called a derivative function.
And that's the slope.
It's also the slope function. So now for any number, this tells me the slope at that point.
Yeah.
So we're just going to pick some number and test it. So this is called the derivative function. I went a little farther than this problem asked me to do. And it's also called the slope function. And to check this, how about we do it for x equals negative 1? So if x equals negative 1, y is f of negative 1, which is, let's see, negative 1 squared times 2 is 2, minus negative 1 is 3. So at the point negative 1, 3, the slope should be f prime of negative 1, which is 4 times negative 1, minus 1, which is negative 5.
Slope is negative 5.
Yeah. So then we should be able to just graph that tangent line with this function and see if it works. So let's whip out Desmos and see if this works. This should work for any x value.
Somewhere. All right, so let's reset this graph. So I just want to test for the function 2x squared minus x. We just calculated, let's see, the y value at negative 1 is 3, right? The y minus 3 should equal, we calculated the slope should be 5. X minus negative 1 would be x plus 1. Oh, what did I mess up? Damn. Oh, the slope isn't 5. What is it? From my notes, it is, I made a mistake. It should be negative 5, right? Yeah. Oh, yeah, that looks like a tangent line.
How did you get that kind of equation again? The 4x minus 1.
Yeah.
How did you get the slope and the x squared?
Oops. Let's go back to my notes.
So, again, are you okay with where I got the 4x minus 1?
Yeah.
Okay, so that was the limit of what they asked me to do. So that tells me the slope. So if I want to find the tangent line, usually I like to do a tangent line as y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. Right. So that's the equation of the tangent line. I know what x1 is. I'm saying it's negative 1. Right. So to get the y value, I have to plug the negative 1 into my function here. And when I plugged negative 1 in, I calculated the y value is 3.
Okay.
And then to get the slope, I plug in the negative 1 here. And when I plugged in negative 1 there, I got negative 5 for slope.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so f prime of negative 1. So that was 4 times negative 1 minus 1.
That gives you the slope of the tangent line.
So that gives me the slope of the tangent line. So if I use the point slope form of a line, I've got the tangent line.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah.
All right. That was fun.